Hi, welcome to Spotlight with Suman, a platform where we showcase different image consultants from ICBI. They are based out of different cities. So my guest for today is Anshu Gupta. Anshu has been associated with me from last almost 9 to 10 years, and she is a very senior image consultant. She is also a trainer with ICBI, and she has been taking a lot of classes with us, and she's based out of Delhi. So let us see what Anshu has to say today, because this is going to be again a very interactive session. And Anshu basically is a grooming expert, and she's also a fashion stylist. Let's wait for Anshu to join in and let's start our interaction. Anshu, I'm waiting for your request. Anshu, you need to send in a request.
Hi, Anshu.
Am I visible, ma'am?
Yes.
Hello,
yes,
ma'am.
Yes, absolutely. How are you?
Hi. Good to see you. I'm awesome.
Usual,
and it's
right?
Such a privilege for me to be here with you.
Pleasure is mine. Thank you for being my guest. So, aren't you all set today?
Yes, all set.
Okay. And how is everything in Delhi? I mean, in terms of COVID and in terms of lockdown situation?
So here the situation is quite easy, I would say. So the shops are all open. Yeah, people are not panicking as much, and they are taking full precaution. So we are just moving with the virtual world.
Yeah, I believe the world has changed for all of us.
Absolutely.
And this is the new normal, and let's accept the fact that this is going to be a new normal for all of us, even when the lockdown is going to open, right?
Absolutely, you know, and thanks to technology. So now I feel that we are more close to each other as a fraternity, and the personal touch is what we are missing, but a lot of learnings also have happened during this time.
Absolutely. So tell us about yourself, your life before you decided to become your own boss. What was Anshu Gupta before becoming Anshu Gupta image consultant? So everybody would like to know about the Anshu Gupta of before.
So I started my journey as a fashion designer, and I have always been my own boss. So the foundation was laid, since my childhood. I was always fascinated towards beauty, clothes, and would get attracted to anything to do with aesthetic. So this laid the foundation deep inside me to take up a technical training in fashion designing, and then subsequently training in beauty culture. So then there was no looking back. I started my own dress line. I used to train people on fashion, and my passion for coaching and mentoring was started from that time. So I was associated with various colleges, fashion designing colleges like Wigan and Lace at Career Academy, and used to train fashion to their students.
Okay.
Right. So that's how it started. So yes, clothing was always in my blood, I would say.
So tell me something. Were you on a sabbatical also before you actually started the image consulting course?
Yes. You know, so what I feel, ma'am, as a woman, we go through various phases in our life, and our priorities changes, right? So similarly happened with me. So I was on sabbatical for about 7 years because I was busy. I wanted to be with my boys, you know, during their formative years. And after that, once I decided to start working again, So I never wanted to get back into my couture business in spite of that love for clothing, but still I never wanted to do that. So why that happened? Because, you know, when I just had that awareness with me, I realized that I want to do something wherein I can touch people's life, wherein I can help them transform. So while exploring various available options, I came across an article, and this was way back in 2011 when ICBI used to promote themselves in TOI. So I read an article in Times of India, and it talked about clothing, grooming, body language, including etiquette. And I realized that this is like an extension to my existing knowledge. And then it didn't take me much time to even realize the fact that this is my calling. And then after that, there is no looking back.
So what has been the biggest inspiration to be a part of image consulting industry? Although you mentioned that it was all about clothing, grooming, body language and all those kind of things. But what was that one thing that really caught your attention and you thought that, you know, this is it. I mean, this is something that I really would like to do and, you know, explore my future into a, you know, a sector where I feel that, you know, I mean, this is going to be very close to my heart. So what is that one thing that really attracted you?
So transforming, touching people's life was, you know, always the top thing for me. Though, you know, I was even doing, you know, very well when it comes to my designing business, my own couture, my own dress line. But there I was just dealing with the aesthetic aspect. However, I wanted to do something more meaningful wherein I could get that satisfaction, right? And money, yes, is definitely a motivating factor. But at the same time, if I'm not enjoying as to what I am doing, then there is no point. So that's how, you know, image consulting happened to me. And it's one of the most beautiful things which have happened to me.
I think most women who get into image consulting, the first attraction is never money.
Yes, absolutely.
The first attraction is always about nurturing, because we are basically nurturers. And it's not just, I'm not generalizing, but I'm just saying specifically for women, because I think it comes naturally because we come after a sabbatical. And we have a lot of, we see a lot of convenience in a, you know, domain like image consulting.
Absolutely, ma'am. And, you know, the very fact, the moment I say I'm an image consultant, something glows inside me, right? I feel so empowered. And then I realize that, you know, how I can just transfer this in somebody else's life. And yes, the kind of satisfaction which I get when I deal with my clients, that is just amazing.
True, very true. So you are, you know, you were a completely different person when I knew you, you know, in the earlier days. I remember when I had come to Delhi and I had seen that very timid Anshu Gupta, who used to hardly talk to people and, you know, I mean, very introvert and very much to herself. So what really helped you to shape up and become a very confident individual? So what has really changed inside you and now you are that very bold and beautiful Anshu Gupta? So
yes,
tell
from
us about
boom to
your
yang.
Transformational journey.
Right, very well said, ma'am. So in spite of me coming from a fashion background, I was not a very confident person. And I need to really share this with everyone. I used to spend hours and hours in the gym. I was extremely thin, 40 kgs of weight. And when in front of the mirror, I always used to feel, no, again, I need to shed some more weight. You know, and I used to go for crash diets, but still I was unhappy within. I never realized that I was so low in my self-esteem. And I always used to look for an external validation from someone. So thanks to ICBI, I still remember my very first day when I met you, my first day in ICBI office, when I met you, when I saw you and other trainers, I felt that you all come from a different planet altogether. So the way you were dressed up, the way you spoke, oh my God, I said, wow, when would I become somebody like you? But I didn't allow this thought, this feeling impact my mindset. So rather, I took ICBI and image management as an inspiration, first to transform myself and then as I aspire to transform others. And there is no doubt the kind of effort which I have put in. There used to be long, long days and sleepless nights. And that time, you know, when we were asked to submit the assignments, we used to just get 15 days. And then I had dedicated one entire room to my books, to my content, to my research work. Nobody was allowed to enter there. And another thing which I really want to share here today. So on one side, I wanted to become an image consultant, a trainer. And on the other side, I was phobic of public speaking. So two extreme things, but I was adamant that I want to be a trainer. So my biggest strength was the fire in my belly to make something big in my life, not for anybody else, but for myself. And I really want to share this, that my inspiration from that point in time and even today is Mr. Agarwal. And I still remember his words, Anshu, you will have to put in little more efforts than others and eventually you are going to reach where you want to reach. So with those words, you know, I started my journey. Of course, my training ground, ICBI, right, which is a wonderful training ground, the kind of clarity, the kind of concept clarity which I have got there. So now training has become a cakewalk for me. So, and of course, my mentor's guidance and my positive attitude, which again, I have taken from Mr. Agarwal, that always be positive in, you know, whatever you are doing in your attitude. So that will take you a long way. So when I look back at my journey, which was like, you know, like a roller coaster, I feel that, yes, I have achieved a lot. First, I have transformed myself and now I am able to really help people to live their life, to live their dreams. Yeah, so definitely, as you rightly mentioned, from a timid person to a very confident lady is what I have become.
Very true. And now you have become very socially active also. So not socially
yes.
active, difficult socially active. I'm not too sure about that, but very active on social media. So tell me
yes.
something. And now Good you have also started releasing your podcasts and you are also doing a lot of work on social media and very actively involved in, you know, presenting and putting across different posts and things like that. So how do you manage to keep your family and your work life balance? So how do you manage to balance the both alongside?
Yeah, so even though you know, in the during these times,
I,
right,
I
social media,
I understand that social media takes a lot of time.
Yes.
I think it eats away a lot of time out of your busy schedule. But then how
yeah.
do you manage to keep your family also satisfied and, you know, managing your social media also, you know, at the same time and, you know, matching the pace with everybody else? So how do you manage
right.
to do all that?
So when I realized that social media is one of the biggest platform and if I want to tell anyone that yes, I'm one of the best image consultants in the country, so I need to be very well, I need to be there. So I just did a small program on social media as to how I can manage and now I have hired few people who works for me. So they manage my social media handles and I am a very, very organized person. So be it my social media, be it my promotional activities, be it my one-on-one clients, I see to it that everything is done much before the, you know, the that particular time, right? You know, I like to be very, very organized and my team understands that if something needs to be delivered next week, so we need to show ma'am today or maybe, you know, 2-3 days before, right? So extremely, I'm extremely organized. And then family, yes, is my biggest strength, I would say. And how do I manage? So I like to live a very simple and balanced life. And I have really allocated, different slots for different things, for different roles in my life which I perform. So when I say that I like to live a balanced life, so my health regime, my spiritual life, my hobbies per se, my time with my boys, right? So everything I have just allocated time. And when you have a regime which you follow, I think nothing is impossible. It's
And how
just that you
important
need to
is
have
having a
discipline.
regime, Anshu? How important is having
Sorry?
a regime?
Having a?
How important
I
is
just
having a
missed that.
regime? How do you, I mean, how
Very, very
important is it to
important.
have a schedule?
For me, it is very important. If I do not follow my regime, by the end of the day, I feel that I have not done anything. Right? Because even when we talk about image consulting or when we talk that we are doing our own business, a lot of time, especially women, they think that, okay, I'm my own boss. It means that I'm free enough. I can do anything and everything, but you have to dedicate those hours every day, be it your work, and everything is important. Like we say, the wheel of life, right? Everything plays a very, very important role. So you have to really take everything in account. And we need to really expand our life. And we women have, amazing capacity to take care of everything. That is what I feel, and that is what I am doing, right? So be it my music, right? I sing, right? I sing classical, right? My health regime, yes, right? I'm very deep in my spiritual life. I chant, I practice Buddhism, so I do everything. So when you have decided, okay, these are the things which you need to do, so then yes, regime plays a very, very important role.
Absolutely. I think that's the key to everything, because if you don't have a regime, if you don't have a schedule, I don't think that
Right.
you can have like a proper balance in your life.
Absolutely.
Great. So tell me something, Anshu. I remember that when it comes to your assignments, I recall that you had done some grooming work for this Miss India Deaf 2001 in for Kanika Bali. And
right.
For her, similarly, later on you had done Miss India Deaf Asia in 2020.
Yes.
So could you throw some
no,
light
that
on
was
that?
Great. Yeah. So, so when I finished up, soon after my certification, right, who gets this opportunity, right? Such a brilliant assignment, I would say, such a prestigious assignment, which I got in my kitty. So, yes, I was very, very happy. And I was on cloud nine. But at the same time, I was panic stricken. I thought that she is Miss India. She would be knowing everything much more than what I know. But let me tell you, ma'am, and even all the image consultants, those who think that they cannot take high-end clients, that they are also normal people. And they might not know the nuances of dressing up or even etiquette. So that was a brilliant opportunity to rub shoulders with high-end fashion designers and makeup artists. And I felt elated that, yes, I'm getting such a wonderful opportunity to train somebody for an international level. Right. And when Kanika won the crown, I felt I have won, like the trophy. So
how,
it was a brilliant
involved,
experience.
How involved was that? Was that assignment? What all you had to do for that?
Just repeat the question. I just missed.
I
you
said,
know,
what
so there's
is
some
the kind of preparation you had to go through when you were dealing with Kanika Bali?
Yeah. So when it comes to beauty pageants, because I have done a lot of work with beauty pageants, but initially at that point in time, her body language, stage presence, how she is going to handle question answer round, and how she is going to project herself as an individual over there, right? So the entire concept of image management comes there. Right. And she needs to be at the same time authentic. She needs to look attractive, and how she's carrying her with that charisma. Right. So the body language, how she's going to walk. And I also collaborated with a lot of other people like makeup artists, fashion designers, because we had to create various looks for her. So there were a lot of learning which happened, during that project. And then I started creating my own database from there. And then, you know, so that really helps you in your business, right? Because you need to have contact details of good fashion designers and the makeup artist. But yes, when we talk about fashion designers, and even I've worked as a fashion designer, so they have no idea about, you know, how to, who can wear those outfits. They would just create beautiful outfits. So here, image consultant comes in the picture, right? Wherein she's going to manage each and every aspect, right? So yeah, it was a wonderful learning experience.
And I'm sure your confidence must have gone on cloud nine after that assignment.
Yes, definitely.
Fantastic. So share with us some of your work that you've done and what kind of assignments are you undertaking?
Okay, so being of, you know, I would say the first mover advantage, I got this opportunity to work with various industries. So I've done various assignments with corporate, high-end corporates, and then even luxury brands, educational institutes, one-on-one consulting with clients, then shopping assignments, and beauty pageant is something which is very close to my heart. So I have trained many beauty pageants, Miss India, Mrs. India. I've also appeared in Zoom television for Image Banani Hai, right? You know, so which was again ICBI's thing. Have written various articles for various newspapers and magazines. However, there is one assignment which is very close to my heart, my first assignment. So I was approached to train a special child who was going behind his age. And I had to really help him to gain his confidence back. So that was something which happened.
I remember you had shared this assignment with me. Yeah.
Yes, yes, yes. And I told you, ma'am, abhi to I've just got certified and, you know, this kind of assignment, because it was a huge responsibility, because I'm not an expert in that field. But again, how to help somebody to gain confidence, and the person who is, you know, lacking his self-awareness. So it was challenging, but I love challenges. Anything which comes easy to me, I feel it's not worth it. Right, so I am born to take challenges, and I have taken a lot of challenges. And that particular assignment also, I did a wonderful job, and till date he is connected with me, and the kind of confidence which he gained in himself. So there was a lot of acceptance. His family was so thankful to me, even to ICBI, that and now he is in his marriageable age. He's running his business. And but I have really worked hard for him, right? Not just in his outer appearance, but the way he used to speak, he used to stammer. So I had really done a lot of speech therapy with him, and then worked on his posture, gesture. So again, you know, it is something very close to my heart, right? Because the kind of satisfaction which I got after that was amazing, just amazing.
And I also recall, Anshu, that, you know, I mean, mostly people say that image management is for rich and famous, and only H&I people can afford an image consultant. But I also remember that you had done under IMPA work with Tihar jail prisoners, so that, you know, I mean, they can be, you know, they can get prepared to see the outside world and get accepted, you know, into the society once they're out of the prison. So could you share some kind of an insight on that as well? Because I think that was also another great experience that you had working with the Tihar jail prisoners.
Yes, yeah, wonderful experience again. So this was a long time back, and you're right, people think that image management is only for rich and elite. However, it is not correct. Image management is about portraying the desired impression. Even when we hire a maid, we interview them, right? We see to it whether they are maintaining their hygiene or not, right? So image management belongs to everyone. So when we discussed this idea with the authorities, they really liked it, because with the kind of taboo the inmates would have, and it would definitely not be easy for them to step out and deal with the outer world. So we really trained them on clothing, grooming, body language, etiquette. So the authorities did mention ki inko etiquette ki kya zarurat hai. So I said maybe they don't need etiquette, but I still remember you told us that manners to chahiye, right? You know. So we really had worked hard on them, and they responded beautifully. Right, contrary to our expectations, they wanted to learn because they wanted again to start a new life, a new beginning. Right, and IMPA is a wonderful platform wherein you know, we get an opportunity to give it back to the society. Right, so it was again something very close to my heart, and not just Tihar, we had even done for Jhajjar Jail, so there the experience was slightly different, but yes, you know, a lot of opportunities probably.
So I think the kind of work that you've done, it has been a blend of, you know, working with the glamorous industry as well as a completely
yes.
non-glamorous sector. So there has been a vast range of experience that you've had so far, Anshu. Am I right?
Absolutely.
So what is the biggest moment of high in your life so far?
Many. Many moments, I would say. You know, so my first training is what I would say. That was, you know, because I was phobic of public speaking. So content and course was never a problem with me. But how am I going to talk in front of people? That was my biggest fear. So my first training definitely. And after that, training in IMPA conference. That was again a milestone which I have achieved. And of course, my IMPA awards, the recognition from the trade body. Of course, it matters. So, yeah.
Fantastic. So tell me, Anshu, I mean, you have got all the family support that you expected from your family members.
Yes.
How do you keep your kids motivated and help them follow image management principles?
Okay, wonderful. So initially, they never used to listen to me, right? It's only when they understood and asked, they saw consistency in me, that every day when I'm stepping out and the importance of not just the image aspect, but even the soft skill, how you're going to talk, the body language, the etiquette. So they started imbibing. Now, when it comes to my voice, even when they have to go down just to give something, so they would first go in front of the mirror, they will see what they are wearing, and then they will go down. And I would say that my family is my biggest support. Why? Because they have seen me as an individual. I am not just a mother or a wife. They understand that I'm an individual and I'm an image coach. So even when it comes to my work, they will give all importance to it, right? So they understand that for 4-5 hours, Mama is gonna give time to her work, right? You know, so there is no escape route for that. So definitely, I mean, that is the kind of support, and 4 A's of image management, it works in, I think, all walks of life, right? So even when it comes to cleaning their room, right? So they would see whether everything has been kept on place or not, whether, you know, what belongs to them, and then it should look attractive, you know, so everywhere they see. So even when somebody comes to my house, they can see the 4 A's of image management.
Brilliant. So
because
what
I feel for me,
say.
So what I feel that, you know, image management is inside me. I mean, it's in my blood. Even if somebody is going to wake me up in the night, right, you know, I would see as to what I'm wearing. So I can't live without it, you know. So that is, it's just in my blood. So of course it gets transferred to everyone, and especially to my close family members.
So I think basically in a nutshell, it has to be a learned behavior. It is not something which you can separate yourself from.
No, not at all.
And I think only then you start believing in the concept of image management. Isn't it true?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Right. Till the time we do not really embrace it from heart, we do not believe in it, right? And we don't practice it, it is not going to come.
Absolutely. So tell me, Anshu, what is the way forward and your vision for next 5 years?
next 5 years. Okay. So right now I'm building on my brand, Anshu Image Coach. And like you said, mentioned earlier that I've already started with my podcast, which is going to be a big thing in the coming years. So there are various possibilities which I'm exploring. However, there is a deep desire in me to start my own finishing school. Let's see when it happens. But at the same time, I definitely want to be one of the most sought after image consultant in the country, right? I need to just train people, right? In whichever segment and, you know, so training is what an image management is, has to be there in my life all the time. So that is what I pray that it should be there. I should be able to train people.
Fantastic. And I think you are already doing a pretty good job. You're already a trainer with ICBI and you have been,
yes.
It's been how long now, Anshu, that you're training with us?
It's almost 10 years. 2011 I started and 2012 I started with ICBI. Yeah, so 8-9 years I would say.
Great, that's a long time.
Yes, and that's a, you know, so whatever I have learned is, so I would say that ICBI is a wonderful training platform because when you are a trainer with ICBI, you need to be high up, you know, you need to be very deep with when it comes to your content. And that really helps me to train outside. Training outside now I feel is a cakewalk, right? Because I have seen that, you know, because when you train image consultant, budding image consultant, of course, right, you are dealing, you're making them. So your content has to be high up there. So again, you know, my own research work, which I feel is one of the most important aspect in any trainer's life. So I would never leave ICBI's training because that really helps me to go much more in depth, to understand the topic from different perspective.
True, absolutely. And once a trainer is always a trainer, Anshu, that we all know for
yes.
sure. And training is
right.
not just about delivering. It's also about, you know, clarifying your own concepts every day. So day by
yes.
day, you talk about certain aspects. I mean, your own clarity in your mind, you know, comes, you know, with
right.
time and with experience. So that also gives you a lot
Absolutely.
Of confidence to interact with your clients and, you know, when you go out in the market and do corporate training. So that really helps
yeah,
you and
definitely.
Takes you to another level.
Absolutely.
Great. So tell me, Anshu, this is one last question to you. What is that one thought you would like to leave your audience with who are looking to venture into their own business?
Okay, so if you are someone who wants to start up your own thing, you want to venture out your own business, don't think, just do it. And identify your whys. Then why do you want to get into your own business? Why do you want to be your own boss? So once you have clarity with your whys, the how will automatically happen. Right. And another thing which I have learned over a period of time in these 11 years, that don't work for money, only for money. So just try to identify that what are you passionate about and how you can add value in somebody's life. So when your thought process or when you would start working towards adding value in somebody's life, you will be successful and then eventually money is going to follow you. But don't go for shortcuts. Okay, let me just do this. Let me just earn. No, build your name, right? Build your brand and then add value in everybody's life. Give as much as you can. And then everything will fall in place. That is what I've learned, you know, with my experience.
That's brilliant, Anshu. Thank you so much. I also get a feeling that, you know, I mean, it's not just about who you are as an individual, but how you shape yourself up. You know, that is something which is very important because there are many people, there are many homemakers, there are many people, there are many women on sabbatical who just give themselves up, you know, with time and, you know, with their kids and, you know, with once the family gets started and, you know, they get into the day-to-day rut and they forget about themselves.
Right.
But I think
Absolutely.
once you fight out all the odds and you understand what you really want in life, this is where you get direction. And this is where you are able
Right.
to see clarity about what exactly do you need to do with your life. And that's something which is very important, you know, identifying your own self, you know, find yourself. That is something which
Absolutely.
I think for everyone, it is a must, because your own identity matters a lot. And I think
True.
You have done a lot of work identifying your own identity.
Yes.
So
Yes, I've done that.
that must be
So,
giving you a lot of satisfaction, a feeling of relief, you know, I mean, in your heart. I mean, that must be really very joyful for you, right?
Absolutely, ma'am. Because, you know, I love, as I said, I love challenges. And it just helps me to come out of my own comfort zone, my own fears. And we women, you know, it's so sad that we always think that we have to live in that cocoon. We can't just, you know, spread our wings. However, it is not correct. Once you decide, and as you rightly mentioned, it is about self-awareness. So once you decide in your mind that this is what you want to do, right? So I think nothing can really stop. It's that inner determination and that fire needs to be there. Then there is nothing like looking back, or, you know, so nothing can really stop you.
And
If
I
I
think
can do
life
it, I think
becomes much
anybody
more
can do it.
easier, life becomes much more sorted when you know that you are
Yes.
able to organize yourself pretty well. And I think we women are naturally very organized individuals.
Yes.
And we know how to sort our
Absolutely.
Life out. The only thing is that realizing that comfort zones are not the right place where you can develop yourself. So you have
True.
To get out of it and make the most of it and ensure that you are, you know, identifying your area where your heart lies. That is something which is extremely
True.
Important, and your passion is something which will drive you and take you to another level. So Anshu, thank you so much. This was a very nice heart-to-heart
Thank
conversation with you. And हम तो जब भी मिलते हैं heart-to-heart ही हो जाता है अपने आप.
Right. Thank you so much, ma'am, for this opportunity. I was eagerly waiting for this.
You're welcome, and all the very best for your successful venture going forward, for your finishing school as well. And keep rocking on social media as you are already doing. And all the best
Thank
for
you,
your
sir.
Podcasts.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Okay, all the best. Bye.
Okay, have a great evening. Bye.